My attention has been brought to an online or online publications alleging that the Heritage Party held a so-called mammoth rally and showing a picture of about six people or so. I am disappointed by this conduct because we believe that media also should have integrity and ethics to verify stories. Integrity is not just for politicians, it's for all of us, and especially the media. I wish to say categorically that the Heritage Party has so far not held any rally or public meeting as such, but we have held what we are calling roadside and impromptu discourse with voters and the general public. This has been a deliberate choice because the impromptu meetings and roadside chats have provided direct contact with the public. Direct in the sense that I speak to them, they speak to me. Direct in the sense that they challenge you as you speak. They question you. They've asked me about my past service in the government and what is it that I'm going to do differently now. And I've been able to respond and explain. Can this happen at a rally? No. At a rally, you can tell as many lies as you want. Nobody will question you. So these roadside meetings are a perfect way to communicate. Apart from being direct, they also provide feedback to the person who is speaking, feedback to those who are listening. Questions are raised, as has happened in this case. For example, here in Chisasa, in Lumwana, there are serious and hot feelings about the past.
If you can see me the way I'm looking, eh?
Yes.
My eyes are turned out, okay. Everything's there.
That's
the damn paper was in... Yes,
again.
It's here, if you can see me.
Yes.
Yes, I'm having scratches all over, you can see my face here.
Yes.
We had an accident just here at Sasa.
Yes.
In 2011, the time the PF were in campaigning.
Yes.
PF killed a lot of people here, but they never even came to say condolences to the people of Sasa here.
Yes.
Like me, some of my friends, they are dead from that time. But we have never seen PF coming to start say, oh, please, this and that. And they never helped us to apologize
but
in that.
How were but they killed? What happened?
We were campaigning for PF. We are youths who were helping to campaign for PF.
Yes.
But after they won the election,
they forgotten
about us. So we are complaining that what PF did was not good. Let's hope even you, when we vote for you,
yes,
you are not going to...
To run away.
Yes, to run away from us.
Yes.
So that's what happened here in Sasa.
You have PF... 1 minute. You heard that I was the vice president?
Yes, I know.
Minister of Education?
Yes.
And have you heard anything saying this man took this?
No.
So you can trust me?
Yes, that's why we are saying we need a good leader who can have peace for Zambians, who can have means for Zambians. Yes.
That's very good.
Yes.
That's why we are here. We want to learn from you on the spot.
Yes.
And then maybe after the elections, because this election is abrupt.
Yes.
Yeah. After and the elections, we are
arranging. Because what, if you can see, Zambia now is now depending on the mines.
Yes.
Most of the big mines, they are from Solwezi.
Yes.
But if you can see the loads for Solwezi,
yes,
see Chingola load, see Mwinlunga load, everything is bad. So
I want to ask you, sir, what is your promise as if we are going to vote for you?
You see, throughout my work, I've never made promises which cannot be kept. Then when I was made minister, I promised to work hard for the Ministry of Education, and I'm sure you know what happened.
Yes.
I went everywhere, I was all over the country.
Yes.
When I was vice president, I promised to help the president and keep peace in the country. So this time, it is wrong. I'm even surprised a lot of our young presidential aspirants, they are promising you the same thing that Mr.
Yes,
Sata promised.
Yes.
That is wrong.
But they never fulfilled their
promise. I don't do that.
Yeah.
I promise to work hard for you.
Yes.
And working hard means I was trained as a military person to plan, to organize, to prepare. That's what we are going to do.
The Zandans, they have to know that the Norwegians, they have complained a lot.
Yes.
We voted, all of us, we voted for PF, but there is nothing which we have seen in this Northwestern.
Yes.
Totally nothing. We have seen quite a lot, of development on television which they have been doing to other parts of Zambia, but like Northwestern, there is totally nothing.
Yes.
So people of Zambia, they have to know that the Northwestenians, they have complained a lot.
Yes.
All those projects which they have been doing, the PF, here in the Northwestern, there is nothing.
It's only in Muchinga where we can find that development.
Yes, which the youths expressed to me. Although it has saddened me, but it has also made me a future truthful servant who's going to report what is happening in Kinshasa. And these things are similar wherever we have gone. We have found similar sentiments. I hope and pray that the misleading statements by those media who deliberately said something negative about rallies by the Heritage Party has been understood in the spirit that I've meant it. It's not a complaint, but I'm just asking that there be integrity within the media as well.